So should you start playing online poker, and is this game even profitable? Now, this is a question we all ask ourselves, and I'm here to tell you that online poker overall is still highly profitable, especially at the mid-stake games. Now, when I say mid-stake games, I'm always talking about 200 no limit, 500 no limit. I think that's the sweet spot, because when you start beating these games consistently, the money starts to pile up. Another thing you got to ask yourselves before you even dip your toes into taking online poker more seriously is, what are you trying to get out of this? You know, I love the competition of playing online poker. I love bluffing people, but I don't do this professionally. I just love the game, you know? So if you're trying to make some side income, or you're kind of like me, you want to play, you want to win, then I think I'll have some good advice in this one for you. Also, I'm going to point out that we did start with $500, but we got all the way up to about $1,500 in this session for playing a little bit under 2 hours. I really never play longer than that. I don't recommend it. Of course, as we are getting into this as well, these hands will be played on Bovada Poker. And if you guys are looking for some great poker sites, resources, bonuses, or want to get on our poker newsletter where we send out one email a week, we'll have some links directly below in the description. Now, let's kick things off here with this spicy 3-bet preflop I made. And I really loved how I played this hand. Now, you're going to notice I really don't have a whole lot on this board, but being aggressive when you're playing poker is a must. You really can't play this game passively. Now, what was interesting here was turn card was a jack, and I checked it over, but check out what I did next. Now, I gave this guy an opportunity to bet into it, but when he made this bet, my instincts of him not having the jack just went off a lot. You know, the reason being, he's betting pretty big into this. You know, if you do have a jack, or we'll just say like a full house, you're probably going to keep your bet sizing a little bit smaller. So this just had bluff written all over it. So I pounced on this right away. Not a lot of hesitation with this play either. And you might look at that and be like, what are you doing? But like I said, there was definitely some thought into that, clearly. And I just knew he didn't have the jack. I mean, I didn't know it for a fact, but you know what I'm saying? My poker instincts, spider instincts were going off right there. Also, because we kicked off this session with that nice little bluff right there, if you guys could tap the like button on this video, I'd definitely appreciate it. Also, share this. If you got any friends that are looking to get into poker right now, or, you know, thinking about trying some online poker, I just think that we've got over 600 cash game videos on the channel right now, so definitely starting to pile up here. Okay, we got really lucky on this hand. I was actually just okay checking it down, but we hit the turn card and runner to hit a straight. This is like kind of just a miracle. So I was okay checking this one down. I mean, pairing a 10 or a 9 here could have been good too, but to hit the 6 on the river, kind of a gross run out if these guys had a 7. Yeah, I couldn't believe I hit that 6. Talk about ridiculous. All right, so this guy put in a small bet. I just made the call. Obviously, if there wasn't a full house possibility right there, I would have raised it up, but I was okay doing just calling right there, and we took it down. Now, for the first, I would say, portion of this session, I was kind of up and down a little bit, which happens a lot when you're playing online poker. You'll start up and you'll go up, I don't know, like 20 to 30%. You'll be up in profit, and then sometimes you give it back. It's pretty standard because you are going to be making plays. And I say this quite a bit because it's the truth. You can't just play ABC poker when you start moving up in stakes. You got to like open your game up a little bit. So you are going to be throwing in those bluffs. You're going to be 3-betting a lot more frequently. You're going to be 4-betting your premium hands, and you're just going to be playing this game different, you know? But these are all skills that you stack on each other as you continue playing, moving up in levels, and it's what it's all about. Okay, I put this guy on hopefully having a king, and I went for value with the aces. I kind of just kept betting into this. And I also encourage you guys, when you have a board like this, you should always be betting this hand. You know, obviously, you could look at it and you could be afraid that maybe he's got two pair or something like that. But, you know, realistically, this guy will make this call a lot of the time because I did miss a lot of straights. You know, we got those queen jacks, ace king, I'm sorry, ace queens, ace jacks right there. So, you know, he could have made that call, but he got away from it and we won a relatively small pot with the aces, unfortunately, but whatever. Okay, so this is always a raise against the big blind, and it is a great hand to have. When somebody plays back at you and you've got this hand, yeah, you're definitely going to be making a call to see a flop. Because if you flop good with this, which is very possible, especially when you're up against one other player, you know, you can make a lot of money. Unfortunately for us, yeah, not a whole lot we could do here. And trying to bluff this guy, to me, I thought about it for a second, but it didn't make a ton of sense. So I did end up just mucking this hand reluctantly. I didn't want to, but I think bluffing here doesn't make a lot of sense. Because it's a pure bluff. And we're just hoping and praying he doesn't have an ace. Okay, a little frustrating there with the jack nine suited. You never want to see that. Okay, another spot where we're definitely calling, you know, three bets all day. You know, this is the type of hand I'm hoping I get three bet with because it's another situational hand where you can make a lot of money with it against, you know, like a high pocket pair, mid pocket pair, any of those ace, king, ace, queen combos. But once again, terrible flop for us with this hand. And just no reason I could figure here to bluff. It just didn't make a lot of sense. Plus, this guy came out aggressive with it, which I would expect. And yeah, we had to give that hand up, sadly. Okay, so this is really the first hand of the session that made us, and I decided to limp here. I think limping every once in a while is okay. I don't recommend doing it all the time, but you can do it with, if you're first to act, right? First to act, second to act, you can mix it in your game. Overall, it depends. You're never going to really want to limp with your big pocket pairs, aces, kings, or queens, or jacks. But every once in a while, I think it's okay. You got some jack queen suiteds, maybe some mid pocket pairs, hands like that, where you're first or second to act. Sometimes limping is okay. Now, this was a hand where he raised it a decent sizing, but I mean, we got the king jack suited. We hit a jack and we hit probably the best card we could have asked for on the turn, which would, you know, one more card here would give us the nut flush. This guy is going to bet into it. And obviously, even if you bet $100 here, I'm not going to fold. I got to see a river card here. And what made this hand even more awesome was that I am going to slow play the nuts. Okay, so check this out. I checked it over. I love that I checked it over here. I feel like this hand is so disguised too because, you know, what we missed basically, you know, the hard flush missed, which looks like it could have our king queens missed, our queen 10 suiteds missed, you know, those type of hands or those king 10 of hearts. And then he bet here. And I figured because he bet a decent sizing, I wanted to turn my hand into a bluff. And that's what I was doing here, right? And he's going to let the clock run down. And I cannot blame him for that. If I was in his shoes and he had, let's just say, a set or two pair here, I mean, this is a really hard fold. Anyways, he made the call. We took down a massive pot right there, getting the great run out with the king jack suited. And that's kind of what brought us up to speed here to, you know, get basically about $700 in profit or close to it or whatever, and kind of just on our trajectory. Now, there's still some good hands to go over here, so hope you guys are sticking around because, like I said, we got up to $1,500 in this session, which kind of brings it all home. I mean, yes, sir. I mean, playing online poker is definitely still profitable, guys. But yeah, I tried to turn my hand into a bluff on that all-in. That's what I wanted it to look like, and my plan worked. Okay, pretty good flop for us. Queen Jack, we've got the up and down straight draw, plus we've got a queen and jack to the board. If this guy bets, which he did, I decided just to come over the top on him, really not thinking he would make this call. But if he made this call, let's say with pocket kings, or even pocket aces, we're technically not in the worst shape right there. I mean, yeah, kings we would be actually because we'd be losing one of our, you know, two of our kings hit that straight. But yeah, I don't know. If he had ace king there, we're basically just taking him off the hand. Yeah, you know, looking back at that play, I don't know if it was the smartest. I'll say that right now, but whatever, it worked out, and we continued on our upward trajectory. All right, so we are going to be dealing with a three bet here, and it was a decent size, I think. I'm sorry, a four bet. He's going to bet it to like $100. And because we're so deep in this, I just made the call here. I don't think five betting this always makes sense because if we're up against aces, we're dead almost. And if he has kings, we're kind of drawn pretty slim. Anyways, pretty dry board. One of the things I was thinking here was he's got a hand like ace king, exactly like me. He could have a hand like pocket queens or pocket kings. Obviously, the aces are still a possibility, but I was kind of just waiting to see how he would react on this flop. And he bet kind of small, and the small bet sizing kind of just felt like weakness. Turn card was our ace. And what was, you know, interesting here was I was still kind of playing this cautiously, kind of just waiting to see what he would do. And I think he checked it here. So, you know, to me, he's trying to make it look like he's afraid of the ace. And yeah. Okay, so the four was a great card. And honestly, I'm thinking pocket kings, pocket queens. Possibly we could have an ace king versus ace king situation. He's going to put in a bet here that was pretty small. Pocket jacks would be really sick right here, but I don't know if he would have four bet pocket jacks, maybe, but I don't think so. So I just made the call here. He had ace queen, and we took down a nice pot. And, you know, him making that decent sized four bet preflop, I don't think that was the smartest play, and it didn't work out for him right there. I think he could have just called me, you know, but yeah. Yeah, man, things were just kind of like going our way, like I said. Okay, that kind of brings it all home. I hope you guys enjoyed each one of these hands in this session, obviously. If you haven't subscribed, please do that. You can also get on our poker newsletter. We send out one email a week, like I said, directly below in the description. As always, thanks for watching this, guys, and we'll see you on the next poker video.